स्टूडेंट्स, चैप्टर 14, फर्स्ट टॉपिक एनर्जी बैंड्स इन सॉलिड्स, राइट। सो क्वांटम मैकेनिक्स लॉज, द एनर्जीज ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन अ फ्री एटम कैन नॉट हैव आर्बिट्ररी वैल्यूज बट ओनली सम डिफाइनाइट वैल्यूज। सी, ऑलवेज इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर मूविंग इन पर्टिकुलर ऑर्बिट्स अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर एनर्जी। ओके, देन सी, इफ एन एटम बिलोंग्स टू क्रिस्टल, एनर्जी लेवल्स आर मॉडिफाइड। If electrons having more energy, then orbit is they are getting that orbit which is more in radius. Okay, so this modification is not appreciably in the case of energy levels of electrons in the inner shells. Why? Because inner shells are always completely filled, they are not free electrons. So outermost shell modification is appreciable. Why? Because of whenever electron interact with the any other atom electrons, then free electrons from the outermost shell are moving, right? So due to influence of high electric field between the core of the atoms and the shared electrons, energy levels are split up or spread out, forming energy bands. Okay, so here if is for example, we have one semiconductor atom, that is silicon, which is having n atoms. So each atom can be associated with a lattice site, right? So now see, Si, it's a atomic number, that is 14. So its electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p2, right? So these are, if you are just calculate total number of electrons, then there will be 14. Now formation of energy bands in solid. Okay, now we are drawing that a graph of energy versus interatomic spacing. So these are energy levels, these are all energy levels having different electrons, right? So here see, 1s2 having 2 electrons, 2s2 2 electrons, 2p6 6 electron, 3s2 2 electrons, and 3p2 having 2 electrons only, right? So 1s, 2s and 2p, these are core state, means whenever any electrons are moving from these energy levels, no electrons are moving freely, they are binding with greater energy. That's why if we want electron to remove from these energy levels, we have to put more energy to remove that electron from this inner energy levels, right? So here now different energy levels, how these energy levels further forms, which is we can show in this figure. See, initially in downside we have valence band and upside we have conduction band. Always electron getting energy from the outside source, and from valence band it will transact to the conduction band, right? So the gap between these bands is known as forbidden energy gap. Now see, what is this forbidden energy gap? It is the energy which is required for electron to move from valence band to conduction band. So that gap, if that gap is more, then we should give more energy to these electrons, right? So yeah, now see here, each n atoms has its own energy levels. The energy levels are identical, sharp, discrete and distinct, right? It's for example 3s and 3p, n is equal to 3 shell, so each containing 2n electrons, and these energy cells is for example 3s having all the filled electrons, right? So these energy levels are completely filled by 2n electrons, right? So if 6n possible, means for p energy level we have capacity of electrons, that is 6n, right? So in that 6n energy level we are having 2n energy, 2n electrons, right? So 6n is the capacity, but we are having only 2n in p energy levels, right? So there is no visible splitting of energy levels, but there develops a tendency for this splitting of energy levels, right? So the interaction between the outermost shell electrons of neighboring silicon atoms becomes appreciable and the splitting of the energy levels commences, right? So here, see, always 2N is not completely filled, right? We are having capacity which is 6N. So 2N electrons easily can remove, so that shell having both type of tendency, electrons can be removed from that energy shells, and more electrons that energy levels getting from the other atoms, right? So here N is very large number. So see, the 1 meter cube volume having this 10 raised to 29 atoms, right? So the collection of very closely spaced energy levels is called an energy band. So here we are having 8N levels are distributed continuously. So apart from 8N, we are only having 4N levels, right? So electrons are only filled in this 4N energy levels. Other 4N levels are empty still, right? So 4N energy levels is separated from the band of 4N unfilled energy levels, and the gap between these energy levels is called forbidden gap. Earlier we discussed about this, right? Valence band and conduction band, between these two band we are having one gap, right? So that is called forbidden gap or energy gap or band gap. So if this gap is increasing, we have to give more energy to that electron for moving from valence band to conduction band, right? So yeah, the lower completely filled band is called valence band, that we know, and upper unfilled band is known as conduction band, right? Then yeah, now we are talking about metals. Earlier we discussed about semiconductor, and in that semiconductor we have take that example of silicon, right? Now metals. So how metals having these energy levels? Metals have these energy levels, first of all, partially filled conduction band with the electrons, right? Then metals having bands which are overlap with each other, right? So electrons can easily reach to the empty energy levels. Why? Because there is so much less value of forbidden gap, which is between valence band and conduction band. So because of less gap, electron always easily move from valence band to conduction band, right? See, which is shown in this figure, valence band and conduction band are overlapping with each other, right? So electrons from valence band can easily move towards the conduction band. So after having lesser energy of electron can move easily towards the conduction band, right? So that's why metal, this easy transaction of electrons, metal have high conductivity, right? So at zero Kelvin temperature, electron getting higher energies, right? And electron move towards the conduction band easily, right? So the energy corresponding to this energy level is called Fermi energy. Which level? So the highest energy level in the conduction band occupied by electrons in a crystal at absolute zero temperature is called Fermi level, right? So here electron get enough energy by very small temperature, electron having this amount of energy by very small temperature, so they can move easily towards the conduction band, right? Now we are talking about semiconductors again. See, you can see from the diagram, there is one gap between valence band and conduction band, right? And it is called forbidden gap. And for semiconductor, that value, actually that value for different semiconductors having different forbidden gap, but here if we are talking about one example, so gap of this conduction band and valence band is 1 electron volt. So what is the meaning of that? If electron having this amount of energy by any other source, then electron can easily move from valence band to conduction band. So here they have give our silicon energy band gap and germanium band gap energy. So silicon having 1.1 electron volt and germanium having 0.74 electron volt. So see, by these values you can say that germanium by very less amount of energy that electron having, by this amount electron can easily move towards the conduction band, right? So at absolute zero temperature electron having this energy and they can easily move towards the band, right? So insulator, if we are talking about insulator have bigger amount of this forbidden energy gap, but still if we are talking about this semiconductor, what happens, not only temperature is responsible to move that electron from valence band to conduction band, there are also some source is for example electric field. If you are giving energy to that electron by electric field, electron easily can get to the conduction band, right? So here fraction is P proportional to e raised to minus eg kbt, right? So that's one formula. Now see, electron leaves the valence band after having that energy, right? And it moves towards the conduction band, okay? So see, whenever electron are moving from valence band to conduction band, there is one position left due to that electron transition, right? So that place is empty now because electron is moving now, right? So because of that empty space, we take that empty space as a holes, and see that empty space before the that transition electron is there, right? Electron was there in that place. So that place having negative charge before that process, but after that electron is just moving towards the conduction band. So we can say that there is a deficiency to that place. Deficiency of what? Deficiency of electron, deficiency of negative charge. So that hole, because of deficiency of electron negative charge, we can take it as positive charge. So always now onwards we have to take hole as a positive charge, right? So that is the work of hole. Now whenever there is a deficiency of electrons, we have to take that deficiency as positive charge, right? So yeah, now insulator, right? So now the turn comes to insulator. See, you can see from this figure that valence band and conduction band having more gap between them according to metals and that semiconductor. So more gap, we have to give more energy to electron, right? So that's why insulator never easily let pass that electron through them, right? Because electron is not having this much of energy. See, you can see that forbidden gap energy now increases to 6 electron volt, which is more energy, right? So electron can't get this type of energy from any substance, for any source. So that's why here electron transition is somewhat hard for them, right? So yeah, here larger energy gap for diamond is one type of stone. So they have 7 electron volt, so electron can't get this type of energy from any other sources, right? Now electrons and holes, now we studied about that electrons having negative charge and holes because of deficiency of electrons, this having positive charge, right? So it is just only deficiency of electron, right? So an electron from the neighboring atoms can break away and can come to the place of the missing electron, completing the covalent bond and creating a hole at another place, right? Electron is moving towards conduction band. Now conduction band having negative charge, but after removal of electron from valence band, Now that valence band having positive charge, right? So hole move randomly in crystal lattice. See, electrons are moving from valence band to conduction band. So we can say that holes are moving from conduction band to valence band. But as we know holes never moves. But by the observation, by oral observation, we can say that hole is moving in opposite direction of that electron, right? So yeah, whenever electron comes to any hole, because there may be in conduction band, there may hole are there, right? Valence band, electron having that energy and moving towards the conduction band. Now electron is just placed on that hole in conduction band. So hole and electron, now they recombine. So that's why we call that process electron hole recombination. So whenever electron is getting to that hole, it is called electron hole recombination, or hole, because hole never moves. So electron have to move toward that hole. Then intrinsic or pure semiconductor. Yeah, now we are taking the example of germanium. In our textbook we are taking example of silicon, right? We can do for both. So see, germanium, now germanium here, they are combined with total, if you are just count this electrons, one germanium atom combined with other germanium atom with total 8 electrons. So they are combined with total 8 electrons, right? See, if we are giving heat energy to that germanium, by what? By just increasing room temperature, right? So electron gets that energy. They broke that covalent bond. Why? Because each germanium is binding with the other germanium with the covalent bond, and whenever by heating covalent bond breaks, then electron free from that covalent bond, right? So because of removal of that electron, it will just now free from any bond. Now these are called free electrons, right? So electrons are moving randomly in all over the semiconductor. So here two electrons are free, right? So then whenever electrons remove from the one covalent bond, there will be hole because of deficiency of electron, right? So hole just behaving as like a positive charge. But here it may happens that electron are moving further, and if there is a hole further, then electron are just put and it places inside that hole, right? So electron place itself on that hole. So here that electron hole recombination many times occurs also, right? So here many electrons are also free from any binding energy or any covalent bond. So whenever there are holes, there may be positive charge, right? Holes behaving like positive charge because of deficiency. So like germanium having energy band gap that is 0.74 electron volt. So we need to give this amount of energy to electron to remove from that bond, right? So 0.74 is the value for germanium, right? So if electron having this amount of energy, electron can easily move from valence band to conduction band. Again another electron is moving further. So many electrons are moving from valence band to conduction band. So here we just think that whenever electron having from this diagram, which is free from any binding energy, we have to think about these electrons are called valence electron, right? So covalent bond just break it out, and electrons are free from any binding energy, right? So if any bond, any covalent bond having only one electron, that means it is called broken covalent bond, right? And whenever electron is just moving from that covalent bond, there will be deficiency of electron, means hole is there. So it is behaving like positive charge, right? So intrinsic semiconductor is a pure semiconductor. Pure means no impurity in that semiconductor, right? So energy gap in silicon is 1.1 electron volt and germanium is 0.74 electron volt. So here silicon atomic number is 14, so 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p2, and germanium having atomic number is 32, so 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 3d10, 4s2, 4p2. See, as in this electronic configuration, you can see that the outermost vacancy of energy levels that have, that is 4. In silicon, that is 3p2, but valency is 4. Again, in germanium, 4p2, valency is 4, right? So, intrinsic semiconductor, thermally generated electrons always equal the number of holes, right? Whenever electrons are moving freely, so there will be hole. So one electron, one hole. If 5 electrons are there, 5 holes are there, right? So they are in same numbers. For what? For intrinsic semiconductors, right? So we can write that Ni is equal to Pi. Ni means negative, Pi means positive, right? So that's called, Ni and Pi are called intrinsic carrier concentration, right? So thank you, students. That's it for today now.